In 2021, Uganda recorded 513,000 tourists from all parks in the country and was ranked in the 99th position in the whole world and contributed about 7% to the country's gross domestic product, or GDP. However, Hangi noted that the figure can be increased if protected areas have good access roads with aggressive marketing.
Most of the roads to these protected areas are not good. For instance, if you're only down to wind, one of the challenges you may get if it is a rainy season. One of us here was complaining about a road to Lake Mboro here. So accessibility to some of these iconic species, these very good attractions, is still a challenge. And that's another area that we need to fix. But also aggressive marketing of tourism. We are doing a good job in terms of marketing, but we need to do more so that we are able to attract many visitors into the country.
He appreciates the fact that accommodation in parks is expensive, but noted that if the government can invest in budget accommodation, domestic tourism shall grow.
That the accommodation in the parks is expensive, and as such, they cannot manage. So if you can invest in budget accommodation, I can assure you, you will see domestic tourism increase. But for now, someone saying, yes, we can spend the 25,000, but when it comes to, if I have to pay 25,000 in Mboro, and one sleep in Barara town, the next day come back. So if this person comes, they would visit for a day and go. But if you have affordable accommodation, this person can stay for another 2 days because, I mean, it's within their budget.
Hangi noted that since 2015, when 15 giraffes were translocated from Mashon Falls National Park, this has increased the number of visitors.
So fast, they are attracting many people to come and have a look at that world's tourist mammal, the giraffe, and plus our famous, unique, and so interesting, elegant zebras, because the colors are really elegant and interesting. Then the impalas, their swiftness, smartness.
Developing habitat manipulation. In the past, our park was more of the open grassland savanna, but because of climatic changes, seed dispersal, the trees have grown so many, they have closed up most of the part. It is more of the woodland savanna than the grassland savanna. And most of the small grazers that we have prefer to graze within the shorter area, the open area.
Evers Tumwine, the Hetisha Ruabatara Primary, one of the schools that have benefited on the revenue sharing scheme of UWA, commended them for giving them classroom blocks.
This school started without classrooms. We started under the trees. After that, we got temporary buildings, which were through by wind.
Lake Mboro sits on 260 square kilometers in southwestern Uganda, and it is well known for impalas, zebras, elands, buffaloes, oribi with 313 bird species. Story compiled by Adolf Fori News.